Hello, everybody. Before beginning my talk today, I just wanted to thank Naomi Hartle and Adam Howell and the rest of the Phys Edagogy team for the invitation to speak to all of you today. Before I begin, I actually want you all, wherever you are right now, to give yourselves a pat on the back, because your decision to join the Phys Ed Summit today isn't a good one, it's a great one. You know, and I say this because no longer are schools solely responsible for providing professional development for teachers. In this day and age, we can choose to be professionally developed in a number of different ways. And today's Phys Ed Summit is all about that. And it's about taking initiative and wanting to grow professionally. So I've seen a lot over the years. I've seen teachers want to apply for PD, and they're waiting for the acceptance from admin or the approval that they'll be sent to PE conferences that they want to go to. And oftentimes they're refused, and they're left feeling actually quite frustrated and upset, because they don't feel valued as professionals. Their requests for professional development are being turned down because the school doesn't provide the funding. So instead of waiting for those moments of frustration and being upset, you can choose to access professional development through social media. And that's why this professional development experience is such a powerful one, because you have chosen to take part in this. And I assume, based on time, the timing of the workshop itself, it's after hours for you, you know? So you've already punched out from school and you're at home, and you are now taking your personal time to be involved in this summit. So I congratulate you for that. And it's just a sign of what's to come. And I truly mean that, because the world is changing so quickly, you know, and the more, the faster it changes, these opportunities are going to become more prevalent, and more people will have a choice to take part in professional development opportunities such as this. And I think the biggest thing to realize with this, and I'll use PEPLIC as an example. Last year, when I came up with the idea of PEPLIC, I was so excited about it, and I spent so much time talking behind the scenes to people like Joey Fighton and Nathan Horn and Amanda Stanek and Doug Gleddy and Matt Pomeroy and Patty Kestel and Joe Bailey and Dean Dudley and Ash Casey and Ross Halliday and Brendan Jones. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. But I spent so much time talking behind the scenes to these educators, because I think they're wonderful people and they're intrinsically motivated to be the best that they can be. And I gave them, Kellyanne Perry as well, I forgot her, but I gave them kind of my thoughts, what I would like to start. And these educators are very, very intrinsically motivated, and they understand the importance of being intrinsically motivated. So we finally got PEPLIC, we had a vision for it, and Nathan, Kelly, and I put a lot of hard work into getting it up and going. And we were very much motivated intrinsically to keep pushing it forward. And then once we launched it, we had lots of teachers sign up, and we got them in onto learning teams around the world. And it was great to see it kind of kickstart and set off. It was amazing to listen to Matt Pomeroy's group and some of the other groups, Mel Hamada, Ken Ford, and them begin to have these important discussions about professional development, in particular areas of professional growth that they really wanted to pursue. And you could hear the passion in people. You could hear how excited they were by just talking about the themes that they had chosen. It started, you know, I'll be honest though, it started to fizzle a little bit. And when it started to fizzle, I was kind of, I guess, taking it personally a little bit, because I had put so much time into it. And without really thinking, one day, and being a little bit emotional about it, I sent an email out to the behind-the-scenes people saying, we need to keep pushing, we need to keep pushing. You know, it seems like it's fizzling out. And people just got back to me slowly, slowly, just saying, take it easy. You know what? You've got teachers that are new to the whole idea of social media. You've got teachers that are new to the idea of, you know, that this type of virtual professional development actually exists. Let them get their feet wet with it. Let them get used to it. Let them see the successes of others. Ash Casey was great. And he he had sent me an email about it. And then Joey Fight, the man, sends me an email that said, you know what, you got to stop worrying about this and just let it evolve and develop as it does. And what you do is you take those small little wins, those teachers that now have buy-in and they believe in the value of online professional development. You take those small wins and you feel satisfied with that. And it wasn't until that point when I realized that Joey was right, you know. And it's the whole idea of just allowing people to be a part of the journey and to buy in when they're ready. And this is why it's so important, you know, what you're doing today is so important, because you are the difference makers. And I mean this in such a positive way, that you truly, every one of you, I don't know how many are signed up for the summit right now, but all of you are truly the difference makers. And in Malcolm Gladwell's book, Tipping Point, he talks about movements like this, you know. And I consider our phys ed revolution, our phys ed online learning community, to be a perfect example. And, you know, he uses the analogy of trains in a car, or sorry, carriages in a train, right? And that most people are still on the first couple carriages. They're, you know, the first carriage represents, like, you know, you don't believe at all in the value of online professional learning. The second carriage, now you got your believers. So there's a smaller group in there. You still got, you know, a decent amount of people, but it's not as big as the first group of non-believers. Then you've got the middle carriage, and those are the real innovators, the people that are willing to take risks and that spend their days, you know, not punching out at 3:30 from school and going home and just forgetting about school. It's about those people that go home and their minds are constantly churning and thinking about ways that they can get better at what they do. In the middle carriage, you have those people. And slowly but surely, it's shifting and more people are moving to that middle carriage. And then all it's going to take is everybody to move one step further, and that's the tipping point. And that's what's going to make a difference for years to come. And we're close. We are close. When you look at the articles that are coming out now in the New York Times and all of these big newspapers across America and North America, they all say the same thing, that science is showing that physical education is the most important subject in school. And it's what I believe in my heart as well, because it's what children need, or what actually students need in general, not just young students, but all the way through school. It's what they need to prepare them for learning in the classroom. You know, and Dr. Ratty's book, Spark, amazing research in there, which supports the same idea, is that physical movement, cardiovascular fitness, improving level of fitness, and being engaged in physical exercise on a daily basis is what's making a difference in test scores. So for all the American teachers, you need to be pushing this with your administrators. You need to be pushing it with the next level up and the next level up. And you won't be alone, because you have this movement that's going to back you up. You know, and I must admit, I don't know if some of you have seen on Facebook or on Twitter, but I've made a decision that I'm going to stop teaching at the end of this year. And it's been a long time dream of mine to just kind of pursue spreading this message. And it's, you know, for me, it's about going out and empowering teachers to do the very best that they can do for the students under their care and guidance, and to push the message of quality physical education and the importance of daily physical activity, and to develop these programs where you're not just talking the talk, but you're walking the walk, and everything you do with your physical education program is about creating a better future for the students in your classes. And this is the steps, the Phys Ed Summit, and being involved in summits like this is the first step. So you need to continue to professionally develop yourself by taking advantage of opportunities such as this. Yes, the face-to-face interaction of workshops and conferences is irreplaceable. I agree with that. But, you know, I use the analogy in my workshops of the sparkler, you know, and the sparkler lights brightly and is flashy and right? But what happens to the sparkler? Exactly, it burns out. And that's what happens after workshops. You go to these workshops that are amazing and you're fired up and you write notes. I've got my journal right here. I keep with me wherever I go. And I'm always writing notes on things to make me better when I'm at those conferences. And then you go back to your schools and you implement these changes, but slowly and surely over time, you fall back to your old routines. And our old routines are not bad. I'm not saying that they're bad. They're actually good practice. But it's the whole idea that, face-to-face workshops and conferences, you know, they don't sustain themselves over time. The effects of these workshops and conferences don't sustain themselves over time. You need something to fill the gaps in between. And that's what social media, Twitter, and phys-edagogy is striving to do, to fill those gaps and to bring educators together. That's what we tried to do with PEPLIC. And PEPLIC, the first stage of PEPLIC kind of fizzled out a bit. There's still some teachers that are doing a lot. You've got Osama Abu Jafar from the Middle East. I was lucky enough to run a workshop at his school. He is going hard at creating a phys ed network in the Middle East. He's doing a wonderful job. So it's still alive, but we're moving over to PEPLIC number two, PEPLIC 2.0, we're going to call it. And it's more about just continuing to create this network and to mesh it together with ideas like what phys edagogy is trying to do, to make physical education what it's meant to be, the greatest subject in school. So the mission statement of this summit is to provide digital professional learning opportunities by sharing, discussing, and reflecting on best practices. And I want you to just think about that last part, the reflecting part, because that's massive. You know, I've said this in my workshops and talks that I do. To me, and you can disagree if you want, but to me, and I'll never waver from this belief, there is no difference between personal and professional. Who you are as an educator is who you are as a person. You know, and if you don't take pride in leading the best life that you can and making a difference to others in your life, then I think you're not going to be the educator you can be. So I believe that, you know, your pursuit of mastery in teaching is really your pursuit of mastery in life. And, you know, it is the absolute greatest profession in the world. And I mean that. So I congratulate all of you for taking part in the Phys Ed Summit. And I want to see more of these professional development opportunities. And I hope to meet you all one day in person, those that I haven't met. But you're looking at four blocks. We've got physical literacy with Kim Haloka and Tracy Lockwood. And we have teaching games for understanding with Mel Hamada. Yay, Mel, out of Yokohama International School in Tokyo. We've got integrating meaningful technology with Christina Krein. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. And we've got standard-based grading with Rich Wiles. After that, you've got a roundtable discussion for elementary school, middle school, high school, and pre-service teachers. So it's going to be an amazing moment of learning for all of you that will continue on and on and on, and the connections that you make will help you become a better educator. So that's all I have to say for today. I wish that I was taking part. I'm quite busy with my family this weekend. My boy's going off swimming and another boy playing football, so I've got lots of commitments, but I wish you all the best of luck and enjoy the journey. Bye-bye.